Hi, welcome to Soul Sharing. So once again, this is our Ask Me Anything segment. And for today, I will be answering the question, what made me become a mindfulness and a spiritual teacher? Well, I'm coaching in terms of mindfulness, and I'm also a spiritual hypnotherapist. But at the core of it is really to teach and to counsel. It all started back in 2012, and during that time, I was still completing my masteral, and I was also still working at a multinational bank. So during that time, I was feeling lost, and I didn't know which direction to take in life. So I joined a retreat, Life's Direction Retreat. And that's where my spiritual journey all started. And what I learned there is really to reestablish and find that connection once again to God, to have that relationship with God once again. And that was March 2012. December 2012, I attended another retreat. And during that time, because the master's program was about to end, and that was already the time to really make a decision what to do next. And what I received back then was to help people in terms of their inner wounds, to help heal their inner wounds. So if the person has mental issues or emotional issues, behavioral issues, even spiritual issues, I have to step up and help them in some ways heal those inner wounds. So that was the start of it all, because after after 2012, I started volunteering to do counseling work. I also did facilitations. And, you know, as you help other people, you also have to learn things, right? So I was studying about spirituality, about our relationship with God. I was also practicing discernment, practicing how it is to contemplate, how it is to reflect. So in doing reflections, in doing contemplations, in doing discernments, at the heart of it all is really mindfulness, because mindfulness is all about awareness. And when you are aware of your thoughts, when you're aware of your emotions, when you're aware of your behavior and even the consciousness that you carry, that's the start wherein you could make actions so that you could transform your life. And that's how it all began. So I was learning to be more aware of myself. I was practicing it, applying it in my life, in my daily life. And not only that, I was also teaching and counseling people. So at both ends, I was doing it. I was studying it. I was doing the practical application, and at the same time, teaching and counseling. So as the years went by, I became more of an, I wouldn't want to say an expert, because I'm still learning right now, but I'm very familiar with mindfulness and spirituality, and I know that it can still grow in time. And the thing with mindfulness and being a spiritual person is that even if you're mindful, even if you're very spiritual, you could still hit through that brick wall. You could still go through a life crisis. But with mindfulness and spirituality, you could actually turn it all around. It's simply up to you how fast you could take action so that you could do the transformations. Because there are times when you just like to lie in bed and that's it. Ayaw mo na gumalaw. So if you're defeated by by the depression or by the emotions or the doubts, it will be harder to take action. Even if you're aware, even if you're mindful, but if you don't do something, if you don't take action and overcome the emotional barrier or the fear, the transformation will be quite elusive. So, but it's a good practice to always be mindful, because when your life is well, I mean, if you're doing okay right now and you're mindful and you're spiritual, it can only get better. That's the good thing about it. When you're going through a rough time right now and you're mindful and still spiritual, you have to find ways. You have to look for your inner strength to overcome the barriers, the obstacles that you've set for yourself. Because all of those barriers are really your own doing. You have to make the choice to either overcome it or allow it to defeat you. So only time can really tell. So that's actually what parang nagturo na ako ngayon. Okay, but 2012 was actually the turning point of my life wherein I started to be more aware of myself and to have a closer relationship with the Holy Spirit. And that's really the beginning of it all. So once again, this is an Ask Me Anything segment. I still have other questions to go through, but sa next week's. It's just that right last week and this week, I chose to talk about personal questions. But starting next week, it will be questions about spirituality, questions about mindfulness, and I'll just do a short explanation of those things just to create a knowledge bank of some sort in our community. All right, so that's it, everyone. I hope you guys would have a good weekend. God bless everyone.